Charlie is an introverted 15-year-old just entering high school, struggling to take it one day at a time after the suicide of his only friend. He's an outsider, anxiously counting down his remaining days of school while dealing with loneliness, his mental health, and constantly being bullied. But everything dramatically changes when he attempts to come out of his shell and ends up befriending a group of seniors that take him under their wings. He's encouraged to start participating and opening up to people, as he quickly develops feelings for his new best friend, Sam. But his inclusion in this friend group has an expiration date, since his new friends are all soon entering adulthood. And so that stress, along with a fresh exposure to some unhealthy influences, and underlying trauma from his past starting to resurface, Charlie's in danger of slipping back into a depressive episode. The Perks of Being a Wallflower is a 2012 coming-of-age movie from Stephen Chbosky, who also wrote the book under the same title back in 99. In most cases, people say the book is better than the movie, but when it comes to this, the movie has the benefit of being lovingly crafted by the author himself. I actually feel they're pretty much equal. The book is told entirely in the past tense, presented in letters that Charlie has written, kind of like a diary. And so everything is entirely from his perspective of any given day. Watching the movie has the benefit of having everything shown in real time. Instead of reading Charlie's recollections with his unique perception, you're like a fly on the wall, witnessing the best and the worst moments of his life as they unfold. The book is a bit strong for a PG-13 movie, and you get some additional insight, but in the end, if you like one, you'll probably like the other. As a theatrical debut for Steven, the movie is well made. Visually, it looks good. Shot on film, it has really good lighting and framing, and it has some occasional unique effects. It's perfectly competent and it's easy to look at. But what truly stands out about The Perks of Being a Wallflower, above the visuals, is the outstanding soundtrack and its musical score by Michael Brook. Music is a major piece of this movie's identity, and it's great, so from a visual and audio standpoint, it's pleasant. But all of this pales in comparison to the movie's extremely strong characters. Logan Lerman plays the character of Charlie to absolute perfection, and this movie nails his sense of anxiety flawlessly. Even if you can't relate with his struggles with mental health and abuse, I think anyone that watches this will relate and sympathize in some way with the social and emotional stress of being in high school. It's an extremely relatable experience. I think most people can understand what it's like to not fit in, at least to some extent. Now that can be said with just about any coming-of-age story, but I haven't seen many others that honestly capture this experience with such sincerity and understanding of feeling alone. Nobody else has it perfect either. Everyone in Charlie's life is dealing with problems, and everyone stands out. When I first saw this movie about 10 years ago, it really spoke to me. I was just a few years out of high school, and like with many other people, it touched me on a personal level. I've seen it a handful of times since then, and although I still think it's wonderful, I can't say it's exactly perfect. It tries to blend comedy and tragedy, and that can be a tiny bit clunky, and certain aspects of the movie could come off as obnoxious. And sometimes the movie can bite off a little bit more than it can chew, especially with its breakneck pacing. The movie almost completely works as intended though. It'll make you uncomfortable. This movie has really tense moments. It has some great lighthearted moments too, and some sad moments. Basically, it's angsty. It's a movie you'll want to watch either by yourself or with a close friend, but not so much in a family setting, because even if you're comfortable with the sex and the drug use, it does have heavy themes of abuse and PTSD. So to get a little more specific about stuff I didn't love, I think the Rocky Horror Picture Show stuff works a bit better in the book, because in the movie, without Charlie's insight, it just comes off as a quirky thing that the kids get involved in, and it doesn't really feel justified for being here. The significance seems lost in translation. Also, three teenagers in the early 90s hear David Bowie on the radio, and it blows their minds. They spend the rest of the school year trying to locate this mystery tunnel song. And yeah, it's David Bowie. It's plausible, but it's just funny watching these kids be totally clueless. Charlie gives Sam his beloved copy of Something by the Beatles, and I was half expecting Sam to not know what it was. Apart from these small, insignificant details, I don't really have anything negative to say here. The movie does so much and gets so much of it right that it's impossible not to recommend it. Worst case scenario, it doesn't affect you and you get nothing out of it. But it's also possible that it'll have this profound impact on you and it becomes one of your favorite movies. The final thing I'll say is that this movie has one of the most motivational and emotionally overwhelming endings I've seen to a coming-of-age movie. The final few minutes end on such a high note that I can't imagine finishing this movie feeling bored or indifferent. I say this a lot, but it'll stick with you. I guess that's just one of the many perks to the perks of being a wallflower.